high at a minimum.
So Ross, if he did all of his shenanigans with his seven, or with his plus four strength, would be 7 times 6. He could literally jump up 42 feet.
Wait, where are you getting times six from?
The boots is times 3.
Yeah, he has 2 multipliers, Chris. It's awesome.
I'm not so sure they dumb. Combo.
No, it combos.
How do
oh
you know
my
this?
God. This is so stupid.
Those two things stack, because one is magical and one is not.
Oh my god. Alright, well, like, we gotta keep that in mind, that's a possibility if it becomes relevant at any point.
It won't really ever become relevant unless at some point we decide that like we're outside. So like, the only reason I asked about how high the dwarf could jump is because we're not going to be in a building very often that has higher than like a 20-foot ceiling. So I'm just thinking out of character, if there is a flying enemy and we need to do something, that is something. Now, the only problem with that is the thing about hitting the ground, although it's debatable, because it can be said that if you know that you can jump X high, then it's going to take that much force to get you up there. So I think that you would also be able to withstand that much force.
Nope, you would take all the falling damage.
That's...
so where is this wind step thing?
I can't find it. It's
monk.
Under key points.
You can spend one key point to take the disengage your dash action as a bonus action on your turn, and then your jump and your as well as your jump distance is doubled for the turn. What I was just imagining was like, remember the keep when we were doing the Harkenwald stuff? It's just like...
Oh, that giant slidey chain to death?
It's like, the prisoner's in the keep. How are we going to get him out of the keep? We have to figure out a way in. It's, he just jumps in, grabs him, goes high, and then just jumps back out.
It's like you're doing like Hulk jumping. That's what that is. You're jumping like the...
Basically.
Smash, smash.
Now, I mean, sorry. That is like 46 damage whenever he hits the ground.
So yeah. That one, again, though, I'm not trying to imply or tell Potato how to run. If I am the DM in that case, I would agree. I would dictate that if you're jumping that high, then you can land that high without taking damage.
As long as it's from that jump.
I would argue
it's from the jump because the boots are acting for the jump.
I would say as long as your fall is controlled, as long as you intend.
But I mean, it's not like monks also don't get to like slow down their fall speed with
BT dubs. I do get slow fall.
Yeah,
some level.
Yeah, some other time. I think that's what Arthur was talking about. So,
It's silly, but technically he can jump 42 feet in the air.
All right. Anyway, let's get going.
Yeah, that was fun to think about.
Yeah.
You can Goomba stomp.
So it actually does all multiply.
You can Goomba stomp someone.
Man, it feels good hearing that statement there.
You are correct.
Mike. Mike's right.
Okay, let me read here for a second, because we got distracted.
Those boots aren't yours, though. They are the dwarves.
It's only about 4 feet high.
Ooh, we're ducking.
So you guys would be crouching through here.
Except the dwarf.
I wouldn't be ducking.
Okay, everyone except the dwarf.
He may bump his head every once in a while. A little tingly.
And it's obstructed a little bit here and there by pebbles and boulders. It might have been a stream bed at one point, but isn't now.
I guess I'm crawling, then.
I'm crouch walking. I'm squat jogging.
Yeah, Mr. Over 6 feet high over there.
That'd be the orc.
Yeah. You're kind of look hunched over.
So what do we see?
As you go this way, that wave sound that you've been hearing? It's getting really loud as you go this way.
Yeah, I figured.
I didn't.
Well, the stream's going this way, which means that it's probably emptying out somewhere.
There's going to be a boat in the cave filled with water and a lake underground. This is a cool map, man. This is so cool. So what else do we see?
Oops. Not that far. Maybe a little bit farther.
Crawl, crawl, crawl.
You see some water.
Does it, like, get more spacious for us to be able to stand, or...
Well, let me go to the thing here.
It's a huge map. This is crazy cool.
Like there, that far out, about as far as that lander goes?
Yeah, I'm just waiting for him to move forward.
Well, I just want to know if we can stand up now.
Once it gets to about where Lazarus is right now, it widens out to be more spacious.
Okay, so he's going to get up and stand.
All right. That is a ledge, just so you know, that goes down into water.
Okay. Show me some light. Show me the light. Wow, this whole stay to the left thing is really, like...
All right. So you see here a narrow ledge overlooking a large cavern that houses a surging, seething body of water. The rhythmic booming that you've been hearing throughout the cave is much, much louder here. At regular intervals, a fresh surge of water funnels into this chamber and slams against the wall just below this ridge. Basically, it slams into this wall down here.
Yeah, I'm looking down at it.
The echo suggests the cave might be one arm of a much larger cavern to the northeast.
I'm just gonna assume that over that way it's just nothing really.
How far down is the water?
That is about 15 feet down, but you can see the water based upon the water marks on it that the water rises about 10 feet and then goes back down every few minutes.
Very turbulent. Actually, water
is literally every 2 minutes.
Yeah, I'm not going down in that water.
Possibly going up and down.
I wouldn't recommend it.
And well, these are like little passages that go out.
Yeah.
Well, we continue on.
Man, I'm so curious as to what's up there, but I'm with Lazarus, definitely. We continue on.
There's a bunch of water up there, so what's up there? All right.
Holy
maybe,
shit, that's a lot of water.
Yeah, maybe an island or something, maybe.
Well, not where you can see it.
Yeah, I know. Well, not where you can see it.
Oh.
Don't you mess with my adventures.
So, left would dictate we go this way.
I have some sort of insight. I'd like to try my hand at detecting magic. Oh, I say, wait, just give me a minute real quick. I'd like to try to detect magic.
Okay. You spend a minute and detect magic, but you do not detect any magic there.
Okay.
So, right. Left dictates we go this way.
Yep.
Lazarus passes by the cavern mournfully, just staring at it.
Shine my light down the hole this way.
You can see that it is a path.
To where?
Going down this way.
Oh, dead ends.
It does not dead end.
Oh, there's like a...
It keeps going.
Oh, there's a... it's just a tunnel in there. Oh, okay. All right. We keep going left then. This is a fun dungeon. Holy crap. I
really like the way they wrote this cave.
I've never had the opportunity to be in a big dungeon so far, I think. Ever since I've played D&D, I've never had, like,
this thing is huge.
Like, Shadowfell Keep, I never got to play it. I never got to play a big dungeon yet.
It's also the rule of left seems to be just get us to everything that we actually need to be at.
I don't know. It seems to... How do you know that? I mean...
It got us to the brother that we needed. It got us a wand of magic missiles.
Well, I guess what I'm saying is if we chose the rule of right, it would have maybe got us to everything we needed to.
Yeah, eventually.
The basic rule for mazes is you always go one direction. Left or right.
That's a weird...
Force.
Those are weird stairs.
They are still just stairs, though.
Come on, Zane!
Mike, you control him, so...
No, I wasn't moving him.
Well, I mean, it's like... being dirt.
Yeah, it was paralyzed, parallel synchronized randomness.
Ooh! I see a door.
There is a door there, yes.
I'm trying to find my light up there.
Let us see. I'm gonna move to...
There we go.
Here for that.
Holy cow! There's a door...
And there's a giant expanse of nothingness over there.
This is all fabricated. This is non-natural.
Is a building of some kind.
Is it a building inside?
Yes, it is. It's a building carved out of the wall.
No, but that's a wall. That's just a wall. It's not a building.
What's that? Well, I mean, it goes up to the ceiling. That is a bench.
Does this go in here anywhere? Okay, so that's not a tunnel. Is there anything under the bench?
There is nothing under the bench.
I shine my light around the corner over here. Just to get a double check. I say, just a second, we'll open the door.
That's okay. Awesome.
Whoa! I see there are some big doors in there. But, how about this? Is this anything?
This is like just a random pirate holdout or something.
This is crazy cool. I love this dungeon. I'm so digging the exploration thing. All right.
I'm in the wall there. Okay. Form up and...
I whip out the crossbow, and if I see a goblin or a bugbear or a hobgoblin,
I take out the staff, I have my shield ready, and I push open the door.
It doesn't make any noise as you open it.
Ooh.
That's weird.
No, that's just...
a little door.
Alright, you can see this is a small room. Looks like it was at one point a workspace of some kind. You see a couple desks with some scorch marks on them, and some broken furniture. There's a table in the middle of the room, doesn't have anything on it at the moment.
And a busted chair.
Yes, and a busted chair.
I step in. And give room for everyone else.
I detect magic before I go in that room, because I'm a little bit nervous seeing scorch marks.
You detect magic. In the other room, there is a lot of magic.
In this room right here?
To the south, there is a lot of magic.
Oh, in here.
Yes. You do not detect any magic in the room you're in.
I detect a lot of magic there.
It's hard to tell what type of magic.
Wait, don't just open the door yet. I wouldn't even stand near the door. I'd like to focus my attempts, and I say, give me a minute, let me think about this. Is it coming from the door itself?
No, it's coming from within the other room.
Is there like a window or anything?
No, there is no windows.
I say, I've detected a significant amount of magic from the other room. I don't know what it means. Wait, I can tell the origin of it if I can detect magic. I can tell its type.
It appears to be a very pure arcane energy. It doesn't belong to any particular school.
Let me see here. I want to see exactly what it says about it. Detect. Oh, yeah. Okay. School of magic. Okay. He says, I examine the door. What is the door made out of?
That door is made out of solid iron. However, it appears extremely well made. And just like this other door, like this door right here is made, the other door that you already opened, it's made the same way. Opened without a noise, it was very easy to open, even though it probably weighs a few hundred pounds.
Blackjack says there is an immense amount of magic in the next room. I don't know what it means.
It's an exemplary work of dwarven construction.
Well, and one way to find out.
Wait, before you open, just so you know the magnitude of the magic, that's a solid metal door. I detect magic through that.
It's not made of lead.
Yeah, one, it is blocked by 1 inch of common metal, a thin sheet of lead, or 1 foot of stone. That's pretty powerful freaking magic. So I will ready my crossbow. Is this a table or what?
That is a table. There is nothing currently on the table but dust.
Give me one moment. I flip up the table just in case, and I'd like to flip it up like this. About like that, and give room for walking on the left. I'm going to stand behind it. Right here, and I ready my crossbow. I'm not going to fire it at anything, but I'm just kind of kneeling behind the table, looking.
I am going to try to open the door, carefully.
The door opens.
Well, like, being defensive.
Yeah, but the door opens.
Oh, shit, no! Yes! Oh.
As you open the door, you see a large workshop that's been badly damaged, most likely in the battle that destroyed the place. There are work tables in the two corners that you can see. Looks like the plaster was burned off the wall, so who knows all that happened in here. There's a brazier in the middle of the room there with a big old green flame that doesn't look like anyone's touched it.
Oh, sweet.
Kind of circling around the brazier is a large spherical creature about 4 feet or so in diameter. It has 4 eye stalks.
Shit.
It's and all as like... you come in, it turns towards you, and all 4 of you hear inside your head, hello.
It's just hello?
Yep, it says hello.
I wave at it.
Wait, okay.
It continues circling around the brazier. Ooh. I'm just not going to move him, but he's circling around the brazier.
I am very, very much paranoid at this. I'd like to identify it. I'd like to try to identify it with my Arcana knowledges.
Okay.
A thing that's floating, and it's got eyes. I, like, out of character, I'm stupid, but, in character, let's see, do I know what the thing is? No, I don't think I do.
It's a giant floating thing.
Shit.
Okay. You're pretty sure it's magical. That's bad.
Yeah.
History.
I'm going to stay behind this thing.
You know there have been eye creatures, but you've never really seen a picture or anything of them. But this might be some kind of eye creature.
Zing says, hi there, what's your name?
Does he have, I actually don't know if he has a name.
His name's Bob now.
I'm standing behind the wall here, just kind of very cautious and leery at this. This is not something I've ever seen before. I'd like to make an insight check about these burn marks.
He doesn't answer you when you ask for his name. What are you trying to figure out about the burn marks? Which burn marks, by the way?
These burn marks.
Are those
burn marks? All the burn marks. I'd like to insight how fresh they are.
Oh, okay.
Give me or investigate. Investigate on how
investigate. Fresh There's they a good are. One to use for this. They appear very old. Like, very, okay. Very old.
Okay.
Like, way old.
Yeah, I got you there.
So, what's your job here?
I guard.
Oh, you guard the place. Well, you see, we are the new guard for this place, and we've come to relieve you of and let you take it, your break. Lazarus is just nodding, hoping that this time someone believes him.
Good job, Lazarus.
Deception check.
A perception check?
Deception.
Oh, deception. A herp derp check. Oh, here we go.
Is that your deception check, Lazarus?
He's hoping someone believes him for once.
No, no. You can't be guards. I guard.
Is it because
What do you guard?
I guard this workshop.
What in the workshop? Thieves. What are you guarding in the workshop? Why do you need a guard? It's all broken and busted stuff, I yell from back there. If he's guarding something, I don't know why I would
be. He looks a little confused when you say it's broken and busted. Says, what do you mean? This is an important workshop.
It has all sorts of broken and busted stuff. You've got scorch marks everywhere.
Magic items are produced here every day.
What year is it?
Are you asking him?
Yeah, I'm asking thing.
You see him think for a second. Unsure.
Unsure.
I do not know the date.
Well, it's 1483. And, 1489, my bad. And it's, let me open the spreadsheet so I actually today. I don't remember it. It is the 26th of...
So he's telling him the date.
I'm telling him the date.
Do I recognize anything on this table while he's doing that?
Let's see.
It is the 26th of Flame Rule in the year of 1489.
You see on that table a breastplate with a gold dragon motif worked onto it, and a very fancy looking mace that has the head is shaped like a sunburst, made out of brass.
I'd like to make a knowledge religion check on that mace.
All right. It looks like it has something to do with Lathander.
Okay.
The guard. That's some out of character idea, but I'm trying to think what he would, Bytek would think. Oh, and Bytek don't trust nothing, especially no floating eyeball with more eyeballs.
He has 5 eyeballs.
Even out of character, though, this is...
Huh.
A very... If I'm thinking out of character about all this, this is very peculiar, even out of character.
So, you say that magic items are created here daily?
Of course.
Where are the wizards and stuff that create them?
Whenever Mormesk returns from his outing, they will be continued.
Who is Mormesk?
Mormesk is my master.
Well, I meant like that was as in a history check.
Oh.
Like, has that been like brought up that he was the original guy that got, offed by some orcs or
maybe a history check.
I would also roll a history check.
Lazarus has never heard the name.
Do 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 do.
You seem to remember that there was someone in this area named Mormesk at one point, and that he was an artificer.
And when was that?
Hundreds of years ago.
Do I know what race Mormesk was?
No, you just know the name.
I asked, your master, what race was he?
I actually have to look at that.
Mr. Guard. Mr. Sentinel Custodian.
Oh, that's interesting. Master was human.
Was that not hundreds of years ago?
Master is a wizard. Wizards live a long time.
He does have a point.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, but you don't need to, like, agree.
How long ago did your master leave?
Unsure.
What are you, besides a guard?
I am an eye beast.
What are all these scorch marks around here?
Results from experiments. They will be cleaned.
Hey.
They happened a long time ago, did they not?
The master cleans before doing more experiments. When he returns, he will clean the area.
I would like to, based on your understanding of chronological events, and simply on the possibility that he is human, I don't think he's coming back.
Why would you say this?
I step out of the fucking line of sight between them.
Yeah. I say this simply from the fact that the scorch marks have been there for a long time, have they not? I point at the scorch marks.
Unsure of age of the scorch marks.
I'm fairly sure that those are fairly old.
Master will return. He will continue making magic items.
Where did he go?
On an errand.
For what? To where?
To collect ingredients.
But where?
Unsure. I wasn't told.
Well, I mean, like, one time this kid's father in my village, like, his dad went to the store, and he didn't come back for ever.
Oh, that's funny.
Master will return. He's looking at you now, Zhang.
Zhang's dancing for him.
I presume Zhang was looking at the stuff on the table.
Zhang was trying to
sneak behind. Actually, I should say, he's looking at all of you, each with a different eye.
That's funny. I'm just kind of half behind the wall, half behind the open space in the door.
So are we okay being in your place?
I am to guard against thieves.
Okay,
not to keep people out.
What would thieves steal from here?
Items, ingredients.
Such as?
That is an odd question.
Why is it odd?
Wouldn't it be obvious? This is a place where magic items are made. What would you steal at a place where magic items are made? Magic items, maybe?
How does he make the magic items?
With this, and he points to the brazier in the middle of the room.
Would he be interested in letting anyone borrow anything in here?
No.
Oh, okay.
No borrowing.
What about trading?
You would have to speak with Master about that. But he is not here.
Are we free to explore the rest of the place?
As long as you do not take anything from here.
From this building?
This is where I guard. You do not take anything from here, I don't care.
You're a funny guy. I don't care.
This is my charge, is to guard this place.
And make awesome puns.
So, how did you come about being the guard of this place?
Master summoned me and charged me with this job.
Speaking of guarding, I'm just going to go back out to this door and just kind of look around out here.
So you were summoned here from...
Indeed.
A special Ibis town, or...
I am from a different plane.
Oh! Yeah, I don't really know much about them besides, like, the rolling plane.
Ibis do not come from here.
Well, this has all been very eventful. I think we're just gonna go this way and out these doors. And I push open the door and, like, gesture
that
for people.
That door does not push open.
Can I pull it?
It doesn't budge. Are you just standing where you were standing there? There?
I'm just standing right there.
Okay.
Kind of keeping an eye out outside.
Yeah, that door doesn't appear to want to open.
I put a bit more force behind it.
Give me a strength check. You push and you push, but the door does not move.
So, is this door broken, or...
Master closes the door when he goes on trips. That door does not open until he wishes it.
Oh.
This is bizarre.
Hey, well, I guess we'll just leave through the other door then. A gesture for Zing.
Zing's got a weird look on his face.
We get outside. So,
I'm waiting on Zing. Zing
just threw himself into eternal darkness.
Zingity, zingity, zingity.
Let's fix that.
Whoops.
You coming, Zing?
Are both the doors still open?
Yeah. We're waiting outside for you.
Where's that mace at?
It is sitting on that table.
No!
Table of the south.
Where exactly on the table is the mace?
Why do you need this mace? Why? Why do you tell nobody anything? Just think about it. Just think about it first.
Right where my thing is centered.
It's like right at the edge of the table. You could... Literally grab it and bonus action run away.
Why don't you just think about it first and talk to people first? Talking to people solves a lot of problems.
Because he wants us to get surprise attacked.
Well, I mean...
And also have a thing chase us around and follow us into the next.
Zing just leaves.
Well, the easiest... Well, yeah, I was getting ready to say the easiest way is this.
Zing, Blackjack... We'll stand here, and he'll be like, let's walk away from here a little bit.
Okay, sounds good. Blackjack is, like, right on the wavelength.
Yeah, we go back to where there's literal deafening waves of...
Yeah, deafening waves of deafness.
Yep.
So, we were hired to kind of clear out this place, and the kid said that it'd be a better thing if we cleared it all out to join his little gang. So I think the thing has to go.
Yeah, I was thinking about that flame there, and the tools that seem to be in the room, And maybe there's some sort of instructions or something around there. Do you guys think that that guy is ever coming back?
No, he's dead.
He's super dead. He is fucking dead.
I would
dead.
Like to make an insight check on that. Can I do that?
I like how Lazarus and Zig were just like, no, he's dead. Just instantly.
If he were alive, the wizard's place probably wouldn't look like that.
All right. Blackjack says, yeah.
At the very least, he isn't here.
So, do we do this the diplomatic way, or do we do this the hard way?
Well, I did have an idea.
I have an idea as well.
All right, let's talk ideas, Blackjack says.
Well, Zing has a staff that shoots out web. A, we could web the thing and then proceed to beat it to death. Or B, he could shoot a gunk of web through that fire and catch the thing in, like, fiery web.
Fiery magical web. Magic-y, yep. Magical fiery web.
Yep.
So those are some ideas.
And then we proceed to beat it to death.
How high was that ceiling out of character?
Ceiling is...
That workshop.
Ceiling inside the room is 10 feet high.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, so it can't just, like, float to the top of the ceiling and just start, like, blasting us.
Out of character, yeah, that's the concern. I don't know what that monster is capable of, Blackjack says. I really don't. I have no idea. But he is flying right now.
Can it see in the dark?
I don't know. As he points to the eye patch, he says, no, we need to be able to... So are we saying we're going to kill it?
Well, it's summoned from another plane of existence.
And I really want that mace.
Oh, wait.
Everybody wants the mace.
Actually, no, I would not be able to know that because I do not have Arcana. Well, I mean, it's summoned from, like, somewhere else. Maybe, like, if we just beat it hard enough, it'll just go back home.
Well, what I was going to do...
Like, sort of kicking like a puppy that's waiting for its master.
What I was going to do was, I was thinking about just grabbing the mace and running out of there to get it out of that room, because I don't know about fighting it in that room full of expensive things.
Well,
those doors were very easy to open for some reason.
I wonder if they're easy to close. I'm just going to say this, I really would not want it to be following us around this place.
That may also be a good idea. I don't know. I think we... surround it and just beat it to death.
Well, I mean, maybe I could grab the mace and we can bring it into that little room. And then...
And then it just starts shooting us up.
We'll be really close quarters. So we can beat the shit out of it when it, like, can't fly away.
Well, I mean...
You guys know that it can shoot anything.
That's why I asked...
Oh, shit. Lazarus wouldn't know that either. Whoops. So, ignore that.
Retconning shoot us. Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, like... Honestly, like,
Did it have big teeth? Did it have big teeth?
It has very large teeth, and you could see them.
Okay, so yeah, we...
It also has a big tongue.
We probably won't be able to catch this thing off guard. Just keep that in mind. It's got eyes looking at everything.
Well, it does have that pattern that I saw. It, like, floats around the thing. So, I mean, we could possibly, like, catch it during that and get it.
I'm just fast, is my thing. I can just run in there, grab it before it has a chance to react, and run out.
Yes, and then it will probably chase us.
Well, I'm just saying, getting it out of that room, I think, is a good idea, well, and then finding
Maybe that might. And then we can surprise attack it, say, on the outside front of the building.
Yeah, that's.
We can get the jump on it. I'm liking this plan better now. You may want to push that table that I set up out of your way. We could drag the table out, also. We can set a trap. We'll set a trap for it.
Well, bear traps won't exactly work against
no.
Floating.
He slaps his face.
No, I know what you meant.
Then how does mentioning the bear traps help?
Man, if you dropped one of those bear traps on it, it'd probably really hurt. Those little eye stalks.
Oh my gosh! Out of character, that's what we do. Holy cow. Okay. I've got it, and I look through my my bag, okay, and oh my gosh, out of character, this is awesome. All right, so Chris, you gotta start right. Just so you know, you're probably gonna have to start writing some stuff down,
such as.
So the idea that I've got. So are we okay with setting this trap? Is this how we want to go about this?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, Albrecht. Okay, so I have more ideas on how to really just lay down the hurt. You've got those bear traps, right?
Yeah.
And your idea, I think, is crazy enough it just might work. As Blackjack sets his backpack down, he's reaching in, and then he pulls out what appears to be a spool of 10 feet of string. And he says, what we'll do, what we can do is, so is this an actual building? Is this like a stone building with some sort of roof on it? Like a covered building?
No, from the outside, it's actually straight all the way up to the roof of the cave. On the inside, it's 10 feet tall.
I had another idea.
Okay, to the roof of the cave.
We've got these benches littered around, right?
Yeah, and so where I was going with this was if we can rig up something on the outside of the door. I don't know if you guys can see down here, but I can blip. If we can rig something on the outside of this door, we may be able to literally drop the trap over its eyes.
Oh my god. I have an idea.
Okay, just don't even skip input on the first idea and just say, "Oh my god, I've got an idea." Okay, so
it deals with that. Okay, well, first off, spider climb also lasts for an hour, so so he probably still has spider climb. Why don't you get above the door, and just, like, whenever it comes out, after you run out, you have two bear traps there, and you just drop them on top of it.
Well, what he'll have to do is, what you're saying is, he has one bear trap ready and rigged in hand. And he runs in, grabs the mace, then runs back out, climbs the wall real quick above the door, faster than the other guy can catch him, hopefully, and then drops it on his head. Or drops it on him, I guess.
Or, you know, just, like, drops himself on him and, like, snap shit out of him with that staff. I mean, you know.
Well, I had another...
I like rigging it up so that it does it by itself.
Yeah, I had an idea with the rigging thing. I'm not sure if this would make it easier or harder, but we have these benches available. And I was thinking if we had a way to make like a fulcrum where we could make like a little seesaw, we could put the bear traps on one side and we could be on the other side. And you could basically just step on it and fling it up at the monster. That might do something. I don't know.
So, this like is my catapult? Idea.
Yeah, like a catapult.
Well, no, well, kind of, but get them from below. So I think what you're saying is that you'd be able to jump on it if he's just, say, underneath it, right?
And then
so
shoot them up at it.
If he's above it, yeah, shoot it
bottom
up.
Bottom half?
Yeah, okay. So out of character, I'm going to draw this up real quick. I'm going to recommend... We do both ideas because we have two bear traps, right?
Yeah.
So what we do with some of this table stuff is we do what he says and we rig it up like this. So you've got this there, and then somehow we rig it above here, and then we can use that lever anytime if somebody is standing right here, right in front of him, fighting him or something. I really don't have any idea how this is going to go down. But if he gets to this square and somebody, doesn't matter anybody, runs and jumps, say, right here on the other side of one of the tables, it'll be good to go. We'll also be able to rig up a table right here for cover, if we need cover. And it'll maybe get in his way, I guess. I don't know.
Well, see, when I'm going to be, like, taking this crazy run to get this thing get back, I'm still going to be able to have the double jump thing because they're part of the same, like, ability. So if you need someone to jump on the thing at any point for any reason...
It may
reason,
be better for you to, yeah.
Yeah.
But what we'll do with the string is the string will have to be about 5 feet or so wherever we think he would fly through that door. And what you do... okay. And what we do is we put the string through there, and when you're running through the door, you'll have to do kind of like a slide or something to slide under it. So you rig it up like 3 to 5 feet up, and then you slide it, and that's the trigger string. But that's just the rest. That's the rest of the idea of that. So what else? What do you got, Lazarus?
Well, the web shooting would also still be like a good idea, because that'll maybe make it not float around, and it might like keep some of its eyes from looking at us so that we can probably get behind it and stab it.
All right, that sounds like a good strategy for if we reach some sort of combat with this thing.
I don't think a bear trap or two is gonna damn.
Is gonna what? Oh, knock it down? No, I don't. I really have no idea. We're just trying to...
I've got a question, actually. If I web it, does it immobilize it?
Yes.
It goes from web from ground.
Zing gets this look on his face, and he looks like back in the direction of where the thing is, and then he looks over the edge of the cliff, and then he looks back in the direction of where the thing is, and then he looks over the edge of the cliff.
Well, I mean, it'd still be kind of like hanging to the web.
It wouldn't be able to not fly. Like, you could probably stick it to a surface or something.
Yeah, that's about all you can do. I mean,
it doesn't
really beat wings, so encasing it in web.
Yeah, he doesn't have wings. I don't know how it's even floating.
I've
never even seen anything like that before.
But I mean, just encasing it in web and, like, stabbing the shit out of it, it's like fine by me.
Yeah, that's fine by me, too. Okay, well...
I'll try and keep its ire on me so that you guys can try and... Yeah.
So what I'm going to be doing...
Don't web it until we've used both traps.
Okay.
We need both traps.
What I'm going to be doing, because I think I can still spider climb, and Zing will demonstrate by walking a complete circle around this entire cavern.
Spider climb doesn't work if you use...
If you use what? You kind of cut out.
Web. It's a concentration spell.
They're both concentration. But that's fine. He doesn't... Once he's out and once we've used both traps, he doesn't need spider climb anymore.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, so that's fine. That's really funny that it lasts an hour, though. That's really hilarious. Like, my god, what the hell have you guys given me?
You probably need to use it again, actually. We've been talking for so long, like, since the short rest or whatever.
No, he used spider climb whenever we climbed up the cliff.
Yeah, I don't know how long ago that was. We've been talking to the dude for a while.
Like, 15 minutes.
That might be 10 minutes ago.
Oh, really? Okay.
Alright, so, I think are we ready to do this?
I can set up the trap.
We can all help set this stuff up.
I'll be the bait, so, okay.
Let's go to the area, at least. Alright, so we go to the area. I'm going to drag this table out here. And I'm going to drag it to be right here. This t- table or bench or whatever it is and set it up here. Thud.
And this is like a bench like attached to the ground or just like I can move it?
That is not attached to the ground.
You can
pick it up and move it.
We'll move it over and I'll fashion some sort of like centerpiece so that it acts like a...
Oh, it's easy. I say as I look at the point at the legs and I say just take those off and use those as a middle point.
Yeah, that plan. And I get to working on that.
This last piece is going to be tricky, though, Blackjack says.
Okay, so how are you guys going to suspend those in the air?
I haven't decided yet. Like, I really haven't decided yet. We can get the string. What do you guys think? What kind of ideas do you have for... Oh, I've got it! Oh my gosh! Okay. I may need a little bit of help. Actually, Blackjack takes the table. He tests it for its sturdiness. Is it reasonably sturdy that at least one character could stand on and maybe a few, like, tools and stuff?
These tables were very well built and are still quite sturdy.
Okay. Blackjack moves it in front of the door. Okay. And then Blackjack stands on it. And he begins to, whips out a hammer, a small hammer. He whips out a small hammer and looks into the stonework and then begins to hammer in some pythons into the wall.
The wall is made out of flat stone as it was carved out.
Okie dokie then. In that case, he looks down at one of the stronger characters and says, hops down. He says, can you guys rig these pythons up to hold the bear trap? You probably only need a couple of them.
Zing.
And then the string will be able to pull the bear trap down on top of him.
Okay. I helped them set it up as instructed, considering I'm Spider.
He's going to try to knock the pythons into the stone wall.
Yeah. What, I got to roll?
You got a hammer?
Yes, he does. I hand him the hammer.
Then there is no necessary check.
Bonk, bonk, bonk. Oh, I was already trying that.
No, I was just telling you what the wall was made of. I never said you couldn't do it.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. I figured I'd try it and then, okay. Okay, never mind. Then I would have done it myself. I'm on the thing and I'm doing the thing. Click, 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 click. I'm just going to use as few pythons as possible. I'll get them when I'm done, but I mean, I'm just using as few so it'll be as loose as possible. And I will rig up the string, say, how high is this door? How tall is this door?
The door is, well, it's more than 5 feet tall, so it extends like, to one square above.
Yeah. So is it eight feet?
The door itself is about 6.5 feet tall.
6.5 feet. So I'm going to put at 4 feet. That 4 feet high is where the single piece of string will cross. And I will ask them what they think about it. And I'd like to use my insight check.
If you want to roll.
But I don't even know how I would use that. I tried using it. I tried convincing him that his master was gone and it didn't work. So this is where I'm at.
Yes, one of you tried to convince him that.
Well, I tried. I really tried, and that was that. And then another character, like, almost turned on me and said, yeah, no, that makes sense. It's like, trying to convince anybody is bad when the party just kind of agrees with the other people. I'm already all in on this plan. I did try. So he rigs up the string, and I would like to check my insight to see if I think that this floating creature would indeed get caught by that string.
Wait, so how exactly is it? Is it rigged so that when the monster comes through the door, it will be pulled, or that someone has to let it loose?
No, if the eye thing runs into the string, then it will pull the bear trap down.
So where is the string, just like across the door?
Yes. It's a very skinny, skinny string.
Well, your insight says, well, as long as he doesn't see it.
Okay. Well, if he does see it, then he's going to see a string across the door, and then I don't know. He may have to spend some time dealing with it in any case. So, whatever. Yeah, I say, I mean, I think I already knew this. I didn't really say it, but yeah, if he sees the string, then, you know, there may be, he may be able to get through it. So I'd like to try to make sure that the string is as taut as possible so that it is as unseeable as possible. And then after that, I step down, I pull the table out. Actually, I already did that because it had to be 3 feet. I moved the table back.
So let me, there is one bear trap hanging there, right?
Yeah, yep. you can imagine it very crudely and simply like a triangle. So at the top of the triangle, there's a bear trap.
I have what it is in my head, but I just make sure it was one bear trap, not two.
Oh yeah, no, we're going to put the other bear trap right here. Yeah, and this is a fulcrum for this big lever system, this big seesaw, and this part is like, I don't know, maybe 2 feet up or something. Something like that. It's a very crude trap, but there's going to be a lot of action for him to process all this information at once, I hope.
Actually, I'm just going to step here, look at that bear trap, like, dangling.
Oh, ignore that.
I have a hunch about something.
I
try to do something while you guys are messing around out here.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I'm pretty much done.
Can I borrow your staff, Lazarus?
Why?
Just a hunch. I'm just.
You're not gonna trade my staff, are you?
No.
Oh, I could go here, and I can get, like, in
like,
here.
Like, this is a crazy idea. I doubt it's going to work, but still.
Can I do one thing first?
Sure.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to go talk to it.
We've just tried that.
I know, but I'm going to talk to it about something else.
What are you going to talk... So, okay, so if you're talking to it and you're going by yourself, we'll just stay out here and assume the same plan. If you want us to come with you, we can do that. But
yeah, if I come running back, then the heat is on.
The plan is on, yeah. Okay. So we just need to prepare, right? So yeah. What else do you need to do, Lazarus?
Well, I was thinking it does have all of those eye stalks. Could try to blind it.
I mean, well, if we chop all the eye stalks off with a falling bear trap.
Well, I mean, like, I also have, like, a pound of flour.
I can't unsee it, Potato. I cannot unsee it. I don't know. I'm all for the, I don't know,
I mean, I was going to throw at, like, the invisible wizard that was running away and, you know, cover him in flour, but...
Nah, he'll just shake it all off. I don't know that it would really blind him.
You ever got flour in your eyes? You know how much that sucks?
All yeah. Six of your eyes.
Anyway, that's... Oh, maybe you can put it up there with it.
That was the plan.
All right, yeah, slap that sucker up there. Blackjack says triumphant.
I will rig the trap to also dump the flour on it.
So are you just like dropping the bag of flour on him?
Yeah.
Maybe have it like cut across the top so when it hands on him,
yeah, I'm gonna cut it across the top.
Oh, and If he doesn't go, if he, like... So for the record, I want the string to be where that blue, that first blue thing is, the left side of it.
Yeah.
Just so you know, I want the string to be, I don't know, maybe there's a triangle from here, from the center of that wall.
I presume right. You have it worked out so it's the way you want it.
Yeah, but there's a specific reason why. So let me change this shape up a little bit here.
Hey, Lazarus?
Yeah?
Can I try to do my thing while you guys are finishing up out here?
Well, I wouldn't do your thing until we are ready and set out here.
Okay.
And I am almost ready and set.
I shall hand the staff to him, and I'm going to wield the talon.
Like, when I come back, I'm probably just going to give this straight to you, just so you know.
I'm going to be behind this.
Yeah, that's about as good as it gets. Can I see the string from here? Hello?
There is nothing in that alcove.
No, can I see the string from here?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can see the string.
Okay. I'm just using the alcove. Actually, no. Yeah, I'm going to be in it. And I'd like to make a stealth check in the alcove.
Chris, this is a lot of work for just that.
This is a super elaborate plan.
But hey, this is so cool, dude.
I didn't say that was a bad thing.
No, it's not a bad thing. It's just like...
There's my stealth check.
You guys have no idea where Blackjack went.
No, you saw where I went.
You saw him go around the corner.
It's just... Bear traps do so little damage.
Well, it doesn't matter.
They're level 1 bait.
It's more, though. It's, you know, we've got lots of options. We've got weapons. We've got... We're preparing for war against the unknown. That's what we're doing.
The floating eye thing of something.
Yeah, really. And what I'm gonna, what my character's going to do is if... I see the eye thing in this square, but not crossing the string. I am going to shoot the string. That is my ready to action. And I am totally prepared. And I tell Zhang, I say, don't forget about the string. It's about 3 feet high.
Got it.
And out of character, I know it's 4 feet high. I told him 3. I'm done. I'm ready for action. We got a table over there. We got that stuff over there. We got stuff.
Okay, this is probably... I've got a plan. I don't want to say it out loud because I don't want to get it confused in my brain. I feel like if I say it out loud, it'll get confusing. But it's just something I'm going to say, and I want to see if it does anything. So I've got the staff. I'm going to go in, and if I fuck up, I'm going to just run the fuck back out with this mace and this other thing.
Oh, and I say, yell if you need any help.
Got it. All right. So I've got the spider staff I'm going to put away for now. I've got the glass staff in one hand, and my other hand's free to grab the mace. Just so you're aware, Chris.
Okay.
All right. So here we go.
This is going down in the... History, maybe. All maybe right,
I'm gonna slowly make my way in. Leave both doors open.
He's still floating around the brazier.
Hey, I have a question.
It turns one eye stalk towards you. Yes.
So, your master, what's he look like? Do you remember?
You ask the character with 5 eyes what he looks like.
What does your master look like? Do you use any kind of special weapons?
Master is a wizard. He uses spells.
Okay. Do you have any kind of wizard staff that he used at any point?
Master had an amulet he wore.
So he wasn't a staff user or anything. You sure about that?
Since I have been summoned, he did not use a staff. He glances at your staff. That item is damaged.
Oh. Have you seen this before?
No, but it is damaged.
Do you want to fix it?
Plot twist.
That item can be fixed, but I cannot fix it.
Okay, how would I go about fixing it?
Have Master fix it.
Okay.
When he returns from his errands.
Another question.
Yes. He stopped moving around now and is looking at you with all of his eyes.
With all of his eyes, intently.
When your master comes back, if he can repair things for me, how much is he going to run me? Like, how much is it going to cost?
It varies on the item.
Okay, so if I say, for example, and he gestures to the mace on the table and this and then the staff, if I needed my glass staff repaired, and I was willing to trade him the mace, and then I also wanted to throw in the spider staff, and then I've also got this ruby locket that is kind of broken too, and I would like him to work on that at the same time. And then I also wanted to do some enchanting. About how much gold would that run me?
I have no idea. I do not know. Each of those things would cost a different amount for repairing.
Okay, but do you know all the amounts? Does your master know the amounts?
You see his eye stalks glancing around the room. I do not see Master's logbook.
As his eye stalks are glancing around the room, I grab the mace and run.
I don't think Potato was...
I spend key point. That one.
I don't think he was ready for that one. That was great. That was freaking A.
I was like, he's going to do it whenever he's like, just like,
As you run, you hear in your head, Thief! Okay, so make your one movement. Well, make your movement.
This super awesome movement.
Okay.
Don't forget.
So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. I'm ducking under the string.
And jumping.
4, 5. And I see these two people. And I throw one of them the mace, and the other one of them the glass staff.
Lazarus catches the staff, and...
I guess that means I catch the mace.
Puts the staff away for his sword.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I drop my hammer and grab the mace in that hand.
Do you keep, do you keep moving?
Yeah, I keep moving. Okay. I'm gonna run up here.
What? He's up above the door.
What? Oh, literally, okay.
Literally okay. Up there.
So you're basically above the bear trap.
Yes.
Oh, out of character, just kick it down if you need to.
Yes, that's what I was thinking.
Alright.
And then I wait, and if he doesn't spring the thing, I'm gonna throw the bear trap on him.
I have to check something real fast.
Are you having to check to see if he actually leaves the area to chase the thief?
No, he will. That's
you see me aiming towards the door with my crossbow. Did I tell everybody that I would shoot the string? I don't think I did.
Yeah.
Oh, I did? Okay. I just didn't know if I told everybody in character or not. Okie doke. Got it. I like this alcove.
Okay, I have a question about how you rigged the trap real quick.
Yeah.
You see, the bear trap has a stake you drive into the ground to keep it there, so the bear doesn't just run away with the trap. Did you do anything with that stake?
I would suppose that I don't care if the iStock thing runs away or not. It's basically an open bear trap hanging on a python, and when the string pulls itself off of the python and falls onto the thing.
Okay, I was just asking because
it's just the bear trap by itself. If he runs, then he runs. Now that would be a better idea. Yeah, if there's like a chain and I you know, say for whatever reason, blah blah blah, you know, he gets stuck.
Okay, he can't see anyone. And he's looking for you guys. And he's going to go through the string.
Does he break the string?
Yeah, and he messes up the string by going through it because he's not paying attention to it.
Bear trap falls.
It falls on him. And there's no save to make because it's right above him.
Do you want the... you to roll the damage?
Yeah, roll the 1d4 piercing damage.
I'm rolling... I'm rolling my initiative.
It clamps down over one of his eye stalks.
And the bag of flour.
Rolling initiative. What the flour?
He's covered in flour, and he's flailing around.
Everyone hears kshank. And oh, Zhang's up there too.
Yup.
Above his head.
Yup.
Do we get a surprise round? Hello? I rolled initiative, but I was wondering if we get a surprise round for this.
Do you get a surprise
round? Yeah, we're all totally ready for this, and he is apparently very, very much not.
He is flailing about.
Like, my readied action was just...
Let me put your initiative in first.
This one I may have to watch again. I may have to watch this one.
Just like, what?
All the eye stalks flailing around. One is like clamped down and it's like drooping and hanging, dangling by this, the bear trap. And
by this 25-pound bear trap.
I would have to say that the three of you, other than Zhang, could have a surprise round.
Okay, that makes total sense.
Hey, Chris, I have a question. Was the bear trap high enough to get fall damage with it?
No.
Oh, no.
You did not specify you were putting it more than 10 feet above him.
Yeah, and if it falls 5 feet to get him, you know, it only falls 5 feet.
Okay, well, I'm going to move in and...
He is covered in flour, though.
I'm going to try and cut off one of the eye stalks. Not the one that has a bear trap on it.
You realize a surprise round, you get... You get one thing, right? Move and attack is not one thing.
Oh, really? Is it not different in 5e?
No, look up surprise round. Just look up surprise, actually.
I'm trying, yeah.
When you're surprised... I see. If you're surprised, you can't take a move or an action. Oh, wait, never mind.
Surprise. I noticed, blah, blah, blah. Surprised. If you're surprised, you can't move or take an action on your first turn of combat. So there's no surprise round. It's just the first turn of combat.
That's right.
So
that's right.
He is surprised.
Oh, he is. We're not. You get your full turn. Never mind.
Okay, well, he's surprised and is granted combat advantage, so...
No, he's surprised, so he's going to combat it.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So I'm chopping at it twice. Well, once. Advantage.
You chop into his eye stalk.
Oh, I need to make a...
And you cleanly remove one of the eye stalks.
He is...
He howls. Growl
very loudly at him. And then I spin around... and go to cut off another one. Action surge. Also, he's...
still have doses.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. I know I've got one, and I'm just saying I would have done that.
Oh, geez, you nail one of the other ice dogs.
Oh.
And yeah. You cut it off. So he only has two ice dogs now.
Good lord, we are kicking butt already. Holy crap.
And he is marked by me. Like, I don't exactly know how to be more menacing than just, like, cutting off more of your eyes.
Yeah. Almost half of your eyeballs.
Albrecht needs to go next.
So I get combat advantage on it, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Technically, this is supposed to go in combat order.
And it also takes a... It doesn't have advantage, or it has disadvantage on reflex save.
Well, what I was wondering is, does that apply to spell attacks?
If it's a, like...
Yeah, you get advantage, because he's surprised.
Yeah.
Okay, then you see a bigger than last time bolt of light fire towards him.
Oh, God.
Yes.
Oh, God, that's
guiding just... light.
Guiding bolt.
Sorry.
I think that's level two.
Guiding light.
Is that level two?
Is it the days of our lives?
Yeah, level two.
Oh, God. How much damage does that even do? Oh, God.
Guiding bolt can do a lot of damage.
That's 5d6 damage.
Pretty much. Oh, that hits.
Oh. Is he just going to be instantly killed in the first turn of combat?
I hope so. But if he's not, I don't care. This is fun. Like, I don't know where this is going.
I don't know why you guys think this guy is, like, super tough.
Because...
Oh my goodness. Beholders are scary, dude.
He's a scary-looking dude.
Oh, he's very scary-looking, yes.
So he gets hit by Guiding Bolt.
He gets hit by it for that much.
Yeah. And... You gonna move or anything?
No, that's the end of my turn.
Okay.
What did you now? The command against him gets advantage again, yep. I guess, so it doesn't matter.
So now it's Mike's turn.
It is the hidden Blackjack's turn. The very well hidden Blackjack's turn.
Blackjack reaches into his coat. He says, what is it? I can't remember. Resident Evil. Are you looking to buy something?
What are you selling?
What are you buying? he reaches his coat and he flings a dagger as fast as he can through the air at the thing.
Roll meat at attack.
SGR. 2d20 DL 1 plus this much.
That hits.
Yes! Holy crap, it does a lot of damage. It has to make a constitution saving throw equal to
I think last time it was like a 15.
What? I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know the dagger that I got stabbed with.
Yeah, anyway, Let's see here. I gotta look at the items real quick, because that has nothing to do with it. Oh wait, I passed it. Element OP. Yeah, it has to save against a DC 13 Constitution saving throw. So let me know if it saves or not, I guess.
He does save.
Oh, dang. In any case, he takes 4 plus 1d that plus this damage. He's lucky today. I will have to get that dagger back. And... After I do that, I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, oh wait, yeah, 6, yeah, that's what I'm doing, sorry. Okay, my turn is done.
Okay.
Oh, and as I'm doing this, I say, I'm sorry, but you couldn't just leave. We tried to convince you.
It roars and attacks. It points one of its stalks at the person above it.
It looks up at you, Zang, partially.
And it's looking at you.
Oh, it's making an attack against someone.
Well,
it's targeting someone, so,
I said it looked at him. I didn't say it did anything.
Okay, well, it's looking at him.
I'm okay with it doing stuff.
You are right next to it. You hurt it a lot. You see its main eye glow red for a second, and little beams shoot you.
I block it with my shield.
Make a constitution save.
Me?
Lazarus.
Does that make it?
Nope. Now you take damage.
A 14 does not make it. This is gonna suck.
Feels like you're rotting from the inside.
No, it's like a... whatever that other eye beast was.
For 27 damage.
Oh, lordy lord.
I don't know how much health you have.
Oh my gosh!
I'm still alive. And standing. Oh.
Then his eye stalk points at you.
Yeah, if it does that again, I'm dead.
Oh, he can't do that twice in one turn.
Well, at least that's not as bullshit as, you know.
And you see a yellow ray fly out and hit you in the face. Make us wisdom saving throw.
Add one to that. My bad. Add one.
Well, you succeeded that saving throw. So it's back to the top, so it's Albert's turn.
Yeah, Lazarus is like barely standing.
Let me check one thing real quick.
Fuck this thing in particular. Fuck it.
You chopped off two of its eye stalks. It wanted you dead.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure if that was, like, literally anyone else in the party besides, like, Albert, they would be dead.
I don't think anyone else has 27.
Okay. Months. I channel divinity on Lazarus and heal him for up to half his health or 15, whichever one's better. Or whichever one's lower.
Well, you see, I was at 2 health, so that puts me up to 16.
You down in one hit.
I had 29 health.
That attack does 3d10 damage.
Wow. Oh, okay. So he kind of got lucky.
He rolled really well on that damage.
Yeah, he kind of got lucky. Okay.
Well, that was the pain train.
And sorry for the wait. I was looking up whether it was short rest or long rest. I got that back, and it's short rest.
Oh, that's every short rest?
Yeah, I can channel divinity every short rest. I wasn't sure if it was long rest like my spells or not.
Channel divinity is short rest.
That's great. Thank God.
Well, like, Lazarus, how are you gonna kill him?
Well, I'm going to do it after I, you know, second wind. So I look basically about the same as where he first did that to me. And then I'm going to drive my sword into, actually, he's floating. Is there a way I can get there or no? Because that door is like...
He is 4 feet wide. He is blocking that door.
Well, I mean, like, the door is like... Weirdly...
No, you ain't getting through that door.
Okay.
Just say okay. He's a DM, dude. It's good.
How is he going to get to... He's floating like a foot off the ground. It's just like there's a person standing there.
Yeah.
A really, really fat person.
I'm going to take my sword. Two-hand it. After putting away the shield. And attempt to drive it straight into its main eye. Every single attack roll I have rolled has been that.
Mm-hmm. That exact same roll. You drive it into his eye. How far does it go?
Eh.
It goes all the way through. You plunge it in down to the hilt.
And I'm going to give like a big display of strength and like try and like twist it, turn my back to and like try and rip it upwards over my shoulder.
Okay, give me a strength check for that. That's neat. You twist the sword and rip it through him as you pull it out. And you'll hear him go, oh, and he disappears. He did not go into the wall. He disappears.
He got vanished.
You see some flower flutter down.
Patink, patink, patink.
You just see, like, Lazarus going, okay. Just, I'm gonna need a moment to catch my breath after that.
You got zapped.
Yeah, you got zapped. That looked painful.
You know, if you had failed that wisdom saving throw, on your next turn,
was I gonna run away?
No, that was a confusion ray.
Oh God, no!
And attacked someone.
Fusion 3.5 suck. It's like roll a d100.
Now,
you roll anything.
Now but... it's a randomly determined creature within range, so he could still end up attacking him.
Yeah, that's why I said he attacked someone. I didn't say he wouldn't attack the eye beast. The eye beast is now dead.
As he's suffering, I reach down into the flower.
No, he disappeared.
No, I reach down into the flower and pick up the thing that was not him.
He wants his dagger.
Oh, the dagger.
Patink, patink, patink.
There's a hunting trap there, too.
I don't step in it. It's already been released, yeah.
I get my traps and just kind of like... Just take kind of a seat on the little seesaw here. Just one of those... Oh, God.
You know, if you had succeeded on that deception tech, he would have went away.
Yeah, he would. If we had literally just, if I hadn't rolled like a 3 on.
I was trying to use a convince thing. I was trying to convince him. I don't know.
I've just been trying that on everyone. It's like,
I know. It's not been working at all.
Well, whenever you have a plus, whenever you have a 10 charisma and no training in it, it's never gonna work.
So
what you're saying is your character's stupid then, because it's like doing the same thing over and over again.
No, he's just wanting to see if someone will at least buy.
Well, at what point does he determine that people just aren't? Okay. Anyway, yeah. So we go back in the room. We go back in this awesome, super duper cool room because this is the best room ever.
So, the chest plate,
it's a breastplate.
Cleric? Or Lazarus? One of you two.
Bahamut.
Has a dragon on it.
It does have a gold dragon motif worked into its design.
Although, Bahamut is platinum dragon, so I'm not sure, I say.
I'd like to make a knowledge religion check just to see if I know.
Hmm.
make that check. You know that Bahamut symbol is basically a dragon, so...
But I wouldn't know if it's that specific one.
It's just a design that's worked into it. It might not be a religious symbol.
Okay.
I'm setting the chest onto the desk. That's what I'm doing.
What chest?
My chest. My little chest. I guess I'll help him identify after I set the chest on the desk. And I'll identify the two items after 10 to 20 minutes.
Okay, you identify the mace. Based upon your identify and the fact that it actually has a label.
it has like a little string attached to it with a little like a work label. Like, by the way, this is this.
Is this like fancy Costco?
What is written on the label is the word Lightbringer. And your identify tells you that it is a plus one mace made out of solid brass.
I convey all the information.
The weapon will glow like a torch when the wielder commands. While glowing, the mace will deal an extra 1d6 radiant damage to undead.
Is that like a free action or is it like a bonus action?
I'd say in battle it would be a bonus action.
Okie doke. I convey that information, then I look at the piece.
I don't think it says it on the item.
It's breastplate.
Yep. I identify the breastplate.
The breastplate is called Dragon Guard.
Ooh, fancy.
And it is a plus one breastplate with a gold dragon motif worked into its design. It grants the wearer advantage on saving throws against breath weapons of creatures that have the dragon type.
Oh, cool. I convey that information. It has a special aura against dragon magic. And that's, I'm going to say dragon magic, that's what I call it.
Even though dragons use the same magic you do.
Dragon magic, dragon coming, magic coming from dragons. Yep, dragon coming from magic, yep.
Oh. It's kind of yes, dragons coming from magic is not terribly inaccurate.
And this is from like a out of character kind of like munchkinning view.
Just put it all on one person.
Well, no. Like, Albrecht has a higher dex than me, and breastplate allows for a plus two. I have a plus one. My AC would stay the same, but I get breath guard.
Probably better for him. I mean, you guys can work it out.
I'm fine with it going to either of us. I would personally really like the mace if you want to take the armor instead.
Oh, no.
Unless anyone else wants the mace. But...
No, trust me, you can have the mace.
Hey, you're taking the mace. That's yours.
It's not to your god, but it's a different good guy, so it's okay.
I think I remember reading something about the two of them being pretty closely related anyway.
They're friends, basically.
They're friends.
Well, it's not really... They're allies would be a better way to put it.
With the best friend gods, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna help get Albrecht into the breastplate.
While he's doing that, I'd like to scan once over very carefully, through all of the stuff on the table, all the stuff on this table, and all the stuff on this table, while he's helping him into the armor, and take off and doff the old armor and don the new armor. Look at these three tables, and I'll tell them. I'll say, while you're doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and check. I'm gonna go ahead and check these tables just for a thorough once over and look through them. And I guess I will roll investigation.
Is there any, like, labels around the giant floating fire?
There are no labels on the giant floating fire.
It's not. I thought it doesn't. Is it floating?
It's on a. It's on a brazier. It's in a brazier.
Okay, that's okay.
What exactly were you searching for on that table?
I was searching all three tables. Of any items of. I mean, I don't like saying any items of particular significance, but any items that are not mundane or not like cups or wheat or grain or, you know, non-mundane items.
I'm looking for anything to fancy.
Well, not necessarily fancy, just... I don't know the way to put it. It's like a cup would be mundane or a... I would not consider a book mundane, so I would look for books. I would look for money. I would look for gems or jewels. I would look for odds and ends.
Let's see. You do find tools that you would believe would be necessary to use the little portable
forge. All right, there we go. Awesome. I look very excited, and I say, I think we're in business, gentlemen. I go back over to the chest, and you're looking at the fire really hard or something. I say, what are you doing by the fire?
Thinking about life.
By the way, I am super, super tired.
I am too.
We are stopping after this room.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. So I take the chest, and I hand it to Lazarus, and I say, can you hold this for a minute?
Sure. Lazarus holds it.
And then Blackjack takes out some of the tools. And he intuitively is going to take the tools, try to capture the coals and the fire, and insert it into the box.
There are no coals in the brazier. It's okay. It appears to be empty.
Then I attempt
a fierce ball of flame.
I attempt to. Use the tool to capture some sort of portion of this ball of flame and put it into where I would think it would go. You said it had stuff writing in there and stuff.
Give me an arcana check.
Arcana check.
Trying to do the thing with the blue flame in Zelda.
I don't remember that one. Arcana check. Ooh, I'm trained in that.
By the way, I went and grabbed my hammer back when I dropped it earlier.
You see me doing something very delicate that I may could use any sort of help possible. It looks like a very complicated process.
I cast guidance on his check.
All right. You're the dwarf.
Lazarus is just sort of staring blankly at the fire.
You manage to get a small amount of the fire using one of the tools that you found, and you put it into the little tiny brazier in the toolkit that you have.
Yeah?
It's you have a bit of it now. It appears to be large enough to be used, but it needs to be fortified somehow.
Fortified.
It's not usable yet.
Well, I'm not looking to use it. I don't know what I'm trying to do. I put the tools away somehow, and then I ask for the box back for a moment. Can I see the box now?
Sure.
I take the box, and I shut the box. And then I open the box.
Flame's still there. And it's not burning the box.
I don't know if I need to insight this or not, but what do you mean by it needs to be fortified?
Based upon your observation of this flame,
yeah,
the big one, it's really, really old. It's been there forever and ever, like many, many years. And just because it's set here this long without anything no one using it or anything like that, it probably could not make magic items right now. So you need to find a way to reinvigorate the flame to make it usable again.
I would like to insight whether or not I think this fire in the box would go out. That's my first concern.
Okay.
So what do I need to do for that?
Arcana, probably.
Okie dokie.
You believe that that flame will not go out, probably for a couple hundred years. It just will slowly become less and less useful.
Okay. So I have to reinvigorate the fire. I say this aloud. We have to for this thing to be useful, and then he claps the box shut and puts whatever clasps around it or over it exists. He says, in order to make this useful again, it has to be fortified somehow magically. We can figure it out. Maybe later, but I don't think the fire will go out, so I think we have something of particularly very neat function here. I think we can make magic weapons and items with this, I say.
How?
That sounds really cool.
It's a miniature forge.
I mean, like, how would you do that? Like, bathe it in the flame?
I don't know yet. Possibly.
I would imagine it's almost as simple as just using it like a regular forge, except using the magical flame instead of what you would normally use.
Yeah.
So, can I test something?
Oh, I'd like to see if the fire would make, like, non-magical stuff magical.
Okay.
Can I insight that?
You can, well, if you put something in the flame, you don't know what would happen, just off the top of your head.
Lazarus is doing it.
So what are you doing?
I was wondering if I could inside it. But...
Lazarus is putting his old longsword.
You could make another
here.
Arcana check to determine whether that is true.
Arcana check to determine.
Lazarus is already doing it.
And Lazarus is doing it, and I'm thinking about it.
Do we still have that bucket?
Mr. Bucket.
I don't have a bucket.
What bucket?
Lazarus, I thought you brought a bucket with you.
Why would I have a bucket?
No, you just grabbed one at some point. I don't remember why.
What are you putting into the flame?
My old longsword.
Okay. Well, after you've left it in the flame for a minute, it starts glittering a bit.
I'd like to identify it.
Okay, after another minute, let me...
I look very carefully at it with my pearl and feather out of my side component pouch.
After you identify it, you realize, hey, that weapon is a +1 weapon. However, based upon identify, you would also know this, it's only going to be that way for 12 hours.
Wow, Blackjack says. It imbued your sword with magical properties temporarily. It's maybe because it's a weak fire or because it's not forged properly or something. I don't really know, but it appears as though you... Man, that's sweet. I put the dagger over it.
After a minute, it starts glittering.
All right. I put the dagger back in my cloak. I put my rapier in it. I'm going all the way. I never know.
That also glitters after a minute.
All right. I put the rapier away. You guys have anything you want to throw in there?
Zing takes his clothes off.
Zing, no one wants
turns
to see
around
that.
A little, Blackjack just kind of turns around.
Zing, no one wants to see that.
Blackjack doesn't make any rude comments or anything, but he just turns around, and he actually steps away from the fire because, God, Like, I'm not interested in fire springing up to life and, like, engulfing everyone.
I think those is closed in the fire.
I go to the desk.
Yeah, Lazarus is just going to be like,
After a minute, your clothes glitter.
Take them back out. Put them on. And then I put the spider staff in there.
The spider staff does not glitter. Ooh. Actually, I should say, when you put it in, it's immediately glittery.
Oh, okay. It's already magic. Got it. So you can't double magic. Got it.
You take care of your clothes yet?
Well, Zing's wearing them, so he's fine.
No, I'm asking. I'm still facing the other way.
I'm wearing them. They're fine.
Oh, you say that. I'm sorry.
Zing squints slightly. Right? Zing will put his huge tent in there.
Huge tent?
Yes, the giant tent I bought forever ago.
After a minute, that huge tent starts glittering.
Oh my god, what the hell?
This is a magical item for you guys. Sweet. Holy cow.
Okay. So now I have a plus one tent?
Whatever that means.
I take off my trench coat and then I just basically, you know, kind of do, like, you'd be sawing down a tree or something, or swinging a baby. That's what I'm doing. Like, I'm swinging the baby of the trench coat through there to be sure it's thoroughly fired. Well fired, and then I put it back on, and I tie back up the vest part that is sewn into the trench coat.
As long as you guys remember, that's temporary.
I put potion of healing in the fire.
The potion starts glittering immediately.
Okay, it's already magical. Done.
How does magic ranged weapons work? 5th edition.
Every piece of ammunition it fires is magical.
Oh my god, I just got a great idea. Lazarus, put your wand in there.
Is it?
Which wand? Your wand of magic missiles?
Did the staff recharge? Did the spider staff
recharge? Can I try to recharge it with the fire?
After a minute or so, it's obvious that it's not recharging it.
Okay. Oh.
Darn.
Wah.
I put a healer's kit in.
I think you have
We've broken the game.
Nothing happens.
It's basically a magical deep fryer. We're just putting random shit in it.
Lazarus looks at it. Looks at the group.
Oh no.
Contemplates something.
No, don't do it.
And then he pulls out an iron pot.
Oh, okay.
So, who's up for magically cooked flame food?
Interesting idea. What do you want to cook in
something
it?
Something in there. Shoot. Oh, Blackjack is going to go ahead and put the crossbow bullet.
Soup? I'm kind of hungry.
You know what? I'll eat it. I'm really curious what that would actually taste like.
15 to 20 minutes later.
We're just fucking around. We're just. I'm gonna cook up some soup.
This campaign's awesome, guys.
Your pot is glittering now.
By He's got magic pot, you guys.
Dude.
Oh shit,
dude.
Is the water inside of it glittering too?
No, just
just the pot.
Okay, well,
where'd the water come from? Oh, I guess you could just. I don't know. I'm not going to ask the question. Never mind.
Well, something I found interesting about the guy, the spectator you guys fought.
What is that?
Under its stats, it says specifically it has create food and water, so it can create food and water for itself.
Okay.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, I cook us some food.
Tastes like normal food.
Damn. But my tent got enchanted.
Yeah.
Zeke goes outside. I'm enchanted too.
There's no rules.
Blackjack, what's the pot do?
I identify the pot. It is only temporary, Blackjack does say.
It is a +1, 1d6 bludgeoning weapon.
It is, I tell him it's about as useful as a magic mace.
Zing will pitch the tent outside.
He pitches it.
The tent is perfectly clean.
Whoa!
Zing will go inside of it and look around.
I put my shield in the flame.
Your amenity glows.
Alright.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna put my shield in the flame too.
I put the lantern in the flame.
After a minute, your lantern glows.
I'm gonna go see what this does. Actually, no, I just identify it. Screw it. I take 10 minutes and I identify it.
Wait, is it 10 minutes to identify?
You don't need to put any oil in.
As a ritual, yes. And what'd you say about that lantern?
Until the effect wears off, you don't need to put any oil in it.
Okay, so I choose not to put any oil in it.
Okay, so what's the +1 shield do?
It gives you 3 to AC instead of 2.
This is awesome. This is like what we need. Of time. But yeah, I mean, 12 hours, that's, whew.
Okay. That's
good for this place. That's really nice. It's like a hidden resource, basically. It's a sigh of relief. That's what this thing is.
I've got one more thing I want to do.
I may have a couple more, but go for it, dude.
Okay. Zing pulls out a deck of 3 Dragon Ante cards. And puts them in the fire.
12 hours.
They're going to be turned into ranged throwing weapons.
The deck starts.
No, I think it just tries it so you can stack the deck, or I don't know. Lots of different stuff, I guess.
Yeah, Zing will pull the deck back out, identify this, and see what it does.
Oh, I identify, yeah.
Cards will do 1d.
So I guess they're a thrown weapon now. God. I'm Gambit, oh my god!
I was actually going for that for this the character that I'm playing, but I ended up changing a little bit. He doesn't gamble, play as much cards as he does Dragon Chess.
Your character from Louisiana.
What? Let's see here.
Hey, I think I want to go to bed now.
Oh, here we go. I'm looking through my items right now. I'm trying to see if there's anything else that would be cool if it was magical, but I'm not really seeing it at the moment.
Oh, I pull out a lamp. It has a canary in it.
What?
It's a mechanical canary. But Lazarus puts it in the fire.
Already magic. You didn't know that.
That I did not know.
What is it?
It is a broken mechanical canary inside a gnomish lamp.
You said it's broken?
Yeah.
And you tell Blackjack this?
Yeah. You asked what it was.
Where did you get that?
My uncle. Well.
Your uncle?
They sort of found it with me.
What is it? Let me see that. Can you describe it, Chris?
It'd be better with...
What?
I think it'd be better if Arthur described it.
Okay, can you describe it?
It's a mechanical canary that looks busted up. Like, not completely, but it's just like... It's obvious it doesn't work. There's, like, possibly pieces missing or whatever. And it's inside, like, this little gnomish lamp.
Little gnomish lamp.
Like, kind of like a birdcage.
Blackjack says, can I see that for a minute?
Lazarus, like, reluctantly hands it over.
Reluctantly. He examines it very carefully. Very, very carefully. And then with a short amount of time, he hands it back to Lazarus, and it's fixed.
No, it's not.
What? It fits! I use mending! I cast mending!
Can't fix magic tools like magic things like that.
Ah. That's kind of lame.
Hey, if you could fix broken magic items with mending, that would be broken. That'd be pretty crazy. Okay, are we at a good place to stop tonight? I swear I'm about to die.
Yeah. Don't die, dude.
Okay. All right, well, that was fun. Hey. Thanks, Chris, for sticking with that.
I'm barely functioning.
I can tell.